My name's Andrea Odenwald. I have owned a Pilates studio for 12 years. I've been in the body business, so to speak, fixing people's bodies for about 35 years, and I've evolved into what I have here, and it's mostly come from my own pain and injuries. I have a passion for people not being in pain. I'm really good at figuring out what's causing them pain, where they're weak, what's not working, and getting them to work. And then everyone, if you don't have a core, you're eventually gonna not have any balance. So you know, if you stay strong, you can keep everything working and moving, and we try to keep you strong all the way around. My background is massage, trigger point work. So when tissues get all bound up, I'm really good at finding the spots and releasing them. And then figuring out, so most people have one thing that broke down. Like if you have a core problem, most people are gonna have back problems, sore back. I'm really good at figuring out what's wrong with you, even mentally. No, I'm kidding. Well, I do that too. I do a lot of shrinking. But it's just, and then getting you strong in those spots. You know, I just read an article the other day about someone, how you can be in your neck Pilates and you can't strengthen your neck. Well, that's BS. You can strengthen every muscle you got in your body, and you can strengthen your neck. And most people are like this, and because we've been looking like this, have no neck. So getting yourself into alignment has a lot to do with keeping your neck in alignment, and keeping your shoulder blades squeezed together and down, your abs engaged, your legs pulled up in those hip sockets, you know, and it's, then you get everything firing. So Pilates is about alignment. If you're in alignment, nothing's overstretched, nothing's pulled too tight, right? If you're like this, you're out of alignment, right? Something's overstretched, something's pulling too tight. So it's about really keeping yourself in good alignment, and then everything's working the way it should. The core is a big problem, because if you even have a tear in your core, which a lot of women who have babies do, or your pelvic floor is weak, chances are really good you're gonna have posture and back problems, back pain, shoulder pain, and then then other things start to break down. Your hip rotators, you know, I always say shit rolls downhill, because if something breaks down, it's gonna all start breaking down, going down the chain. So we got to start with the thing that's the weakest and work our way up. And it takes a lot of mental energy. Because like if you're a runner, people use that as more like a mental enema, because they can run, they don't have to think about anything. Here, all you can think about is yourself. What am I doing? Where am I in my body? What's moving? Most people have no idea where they are in space, and it's kind of important to know where you are in space to keep yourself aligned. I'm not your mother, I'm not your babysitter. If you want help, I will help you, but I'm not gonna hold your hand. This takes consistency, and you really need to do it for the rest of your life. And you need to know that, and you need to be committed. And of course, it's not a cheap feat. So but like a lot of my clients, you say, pay now or pay later, right? If you pay now and you keep yourself strong, you have a strong core, it's gonna give you balance, you're gonna be able to, and you're not gonna leak pee or anything else is gonna fall out of you, because if your pelvic floor is weak, a lot of problems. So it keeps you strong, it keeps you moving. If you twist and turn your spine, you will stay young forever. And if you see people who can't twist and turn their spine, here they are, right? So the more you move, the more you twist, the more you tune, the more strength you have, the more balance you have, the more you're gonna keep yourself upright. Because when you're old, if you fall, it is bad. You know, it's the beginning of the end for most people, and we don't want that. But if you have a strong core and you're in alignment, chances are pretty good you're not gonna fall, unless it's sheer ice and there's nothing you can do about it. But we, you know, if you're all over the place, you can't catch yourself. When you're in alignment, if you slip, you can upright yourself. I've got kids from 12 to, I think my oldest person's 86. But if you look at these older people, they're beautiful. They can move, they can twist and turn, they can walk. One wanted to just make sure she could walk on the Sahara, and she did. The problem is that I probably am going to have to stay small, because I learned how to do this work from so many different modalities, and I'm very intuitive with the body. You can't teach people this, you know, that's the problem. I wanted to grow my business, and they basically said, you have to quit and do sales, which is fine. I'm a closer, I'm good at sales, but I can't find the people or train the people to do what I do. When I kind of realized that, that's when I changed this practice from letting anybody in, you know, just giving them like 4 or 5 private trainings, having them come to class, wasn't working. I needed you to be more commitment, so I need you to come in and make a commitment. I'm making a commitment to you, make a commitment to me, and then we got a lot of happy people. Most of my other people have been coming 10 years, 12 years, 7 years, 9 years, yeah. So I started out when I was doing massage. I lived in New York for a long time, and I started doing massage a couple miles from here. And then I moved, then I was in Navarre, and I liked it there, but it really wasn't my demographic. This is my demographic. This is not a cheap feat. Pilates is expensive, and it takes commitment, so you have to be able to have that to start out with. You know, I started this business with no money. I worked for a lot of years with no money. So I would say, get a backer, get someone, get a bank, get someone that will help you out. I mean, banks are, you know, harder when you first start out, but I was really lucky because I had a lot of really dedicated clients who actually, when I needed help, would pay up front for a couple months so it's really about planning and having enough money, because I mean there was a lot of times where it was really tough, and you know I didn't know that there was entrepreneurial banks that wanted to help entrepreneurs. I didn't know that. I mean, I had applied for different stuff down the years, but you know, you never get it. You don't know how to fight for it. You don't know how to. So, and also maybe taking a business class, because there's so much I didn't know about, you know, business and employees and, you know, Secretary of State. And also when you're really micro business, you can't hire people to really do that. So you got to figure it out on your own. And, you know, that also takes a lot of time. And then when you're working, you know, with clients 50 hours a week, and then you gotta do all the other stuff, so it gets to be a lot. So maybe if you plan better, you know, I've always kind of been by the seat of my pants person, and it's a lot of things haven't worked out. This happened to work out, but yeah, I do really love what I do, and I do love helping people, making them better, getting them out of pain, is a really big. It just makes you feel really good.